The following is a presentation of Santa Monica College.
Santa Monica Corsairs hosting the College of the Canyons here for the first conference matchup of the season. I'm Kevin Coe for my partner Josh Schur. Thank you here for joining us on this beautiful, arguably beautiful day here in Southern California. Now, Josh, we have a very interesting game here for the first game for the Corsairs. College of the Canyons coming here, a red-hot team. They got the Twin Towers that we were alluding to pregame. Tell us what the Corsairs have to do tonight to get this W.
They're going to have to eat up the boards. They're going to have to win the battle on the boards. You're looking at a College of the Canyon Cougars team that have Monica Friedel and Hannah Green, arguably probably two of the best forwards and post players in all of the JUCO California State basketball.
And you're not being sarcastic there. They are arguably,
they
two,
are
of the top
arguably two of the top players. So look for both of them to try to attack the glass, eat up a lot of boards, and look for Coach Strong to try to put some big bodies down low and try to stop those two big twin towers for being able to grab offensive boards and even be able to control the defensive boards. So look for Seka as well as Robin Ashkenazi for grabbing some offensive boards down low and trying to control the glass. So if any chance of staying in this game, you're going to have to at least keep the battle on the boards close.
Looks like the Corsairs are going to have their hands full with this one. Down on the sidelines, we have sideline reporter Kelly Tittle, who's down on the court.
The SMC Corsairs versus College of the Canyons Cougars, a conference opener for both teams. The Corsairs are coming in with a record of 4-10, where the Cougars are at 10-4. The Cougars are currently ranked 18th in the state, so it will be an interesting game, to say the least. Kevin, Josh.
Corsairs hosting the College of the Canyon Cougars here in the first Western Conference matchup of the season. I'm Kevin Cohen for my partner, Josh Schur. Thank you for joining us here today in what should be a great matchup. Now, starting lineups are being introduced right now, but Josh, this should be a great opener for both teams. Now, both teams have played. This is the first conference game, but they both have game experience. What are you looking for here tonight so that the Cougars, or that the Corsairs come out with a win?
The Corsairs will definitely have to look to keep off the two big towers down below for the Cougars off the glass. Those two would be Hannah Green and Monica Friedel. You really have to watch those two. Both of them are averaging in double digits in rebounds. And the Cougars as a whole are out-rebounding other teams they face up against by about 5 boards per game, while the Corsairs are usually getting out-rebounded by nearly 11 rebounds per game. So definitely look for the Corsairs to try to win the battle on the glass. It'll definitely be a tough task for them, but let's see if they can be up for the challenge.
As Josh said, look for Friedel and Green over on the Cougar side of the ball. They are, you know, as Josh said, kind of like a Twin Towers thing going on for the Canyons. Now, the Corsairs coming into this game at 4-10. Head coach Lydia Strong prepared them, really. It's been a tumultuous season. You could say a bit of a rough to get here, but they're here, they're ready, and we should have a great game here tonight. Looks like we're about ready for tip-off.
Looks like we'll have Friedel and Mamusu Seka going off for the tip-off right here.
Friedel, as you were talking about, arguably the best player on this team, really.
Definitely. She was all Western Conference first team state player of the year last year, and she's back at it again this year.
Here we go, and just like that, another Western Conference season. Number 4, Rojas up at top, pressured up top. Good get by O'Brien, gives it in, and ooh. It's a good shot there, but the Corsair is going to bring it the other way. Oop, inside. Tried to get it in there. I mean, good intentions, but luckily the Corsairs get the ball back there.
You can watch the Cougars look to feed their two big girls down low, especially early.
Corsairs. Roberta Hayes inside. ball going off quite a number of people. Unluckily, that goes out on Seca outside. Speaking of Seca, she's actually from Sweden, interestingly enough, playing here in Santa Monica.
Yeah, and she's one big girl. Look at her down low. She's going to be in a battle all game long with Monica Frieda.
Corsairs opting for a full court press. They're going to have to get back if they want to stop the Cougars on the other end. Now, the College of the Canyon Cougars, very loaded on the offensive end. They're going to try to go inside to Friedel and Green.
Looks like they're trying to find a way to get the ball to Green down low.
Whipping the ground inside to Green, just like
there's
you were
pass.
Saying. Look at Green getting it inside. The hook shot.
Misses.
Out.
Offensive rebound by Friedel. Put back. Miss.
Luckily, the ball didn't go in there for the Corsairs, but as you were saying, the offensive rebounds is a key thing to look for in this game. Chavez, going to be Corsairs' ball.
Especially with Green and Friedel. Both of them in the last five games alone combined are averaging about 8 offensive boards. So look for them to eat up those offensive boards and look for second chance points for the Cougars.
Flores is going to inbound the ball there to Hayes. Back outside. Looks like Gray is going to try to get something going here. Down to the left side. Going around the screen. She's going to drive inside. Oh, back out to Gray. There's going to be a travel call. Turnover for the Corsairs. They're going to have to watch out for those tonight.
Definitely. You can't give away the ball like that. You're going to have to be able to convert on some of these possessions, especially early when the Cougars aren't able to score.
Corsairs sticking with that full court press. Looks like they triple team Friedel over there. They get the turnover. Corsairs going to try to run a fast break on the other end. Gray, looked for the streaking Hayes. Threw it behind her. Looks like another fast break at the other end. For three. Oh, and it's good. Right there by O'Brien. Like we said, first 3 points of the game, but very offensively talented Cougars team we have here tonight. Oh, great. Gonna lose the ball, actually. It's gonna be a foul. Turnover by O'Shyla Gray. Now, that was a turnover right there, but Gray, really a leader for this team. Handles the ball and does a really good job of keeping this offense under control.
Yeah, definitely. You can't be turning the ball over this early, especially up against a great team like the Cougars who are going to be piling some points on.
Another three-pointer there by Kylie. It's not going to go in.
You can really see the Corsairs are loading the key. Every time a shot goes up, they're looking to try to win the boards battle early.
Corsairs going to try to attack inside. Fake. Up and in by Hayes, not going to be good. Looks like the Corsairs, though, really trying to push the tempo in the beginning of this game. Cougars running it into Green. She can't quite handle it. Outside to Friedel. Up. And that's in. And one for Friedel. That's exactly who we were talking about before this game.
I'd definitely say get used to watching the ball go in every time the ball Friedel gets a chance to put the ball up. In the last five games alone, she's averaging 23 points per game. Misses the free throw.
Rebounded there by Seca. Now, press up top. Looks like the Corsairs trying to get something here on offense. They haven't had much success. Gonna call the foul.
Foul on Friedel on the outside.
She was working on her defense pregame. She might be a little angsty here. Corsairs just looking to get something on the board. They're down 5-0. Gray up top. Looks like she's going to go ISO here. Jump shot. She
another
got foul.
Another foul on Friedel, which is not going to be good for the Cougars, especially with them with her being the star player of the team. Early foul trouble might be putting her on the bench early.
Now, Melissa Friedel. Two fouls already, like you were saying, but that's got to be great for the Corsairs.
That's exactly what you'd want right now if you're Coach Strong. You have the top scorer on the team who's averaging nearly 20 points per game, as well as about 11 boards in early foul trouble. So definitely look for Coach Strong to try to feed the ball into the post early, or now with Friedel with two fouls, and see if they can get some of the other players into foul trouble for the Cougars.
Friedel comes out with those two fouls. In comes Sarah Ward. Corsairs have the point. Looking for a second one. There we go. 5-2. Cougars. Now, Corsairs still opting with this full court press. They're going to try to force the issue here, create a lot of turnovers, trapping people in the corners. Inside, up, in. Ooh, and the fall. Falls down hard. Sierra O'Brien, she's going to shoot two. It's 5-2 Cougars here with 6:35 left in the first. First one is good.
Let's see if they can get the offensive board. Hannah Green's going to go after it.
One is off. It's going to go the other way.
Be a foul. Very close of grabbing the offensive board there. Definitely, again, look for the Cougars on the boards. They love going after offensive boards. They love those second chance points. They love fighting for it.
Now keep in mind, Friedel is out, but you do still have Hannah Green.
You do have Hannah Green. And Hannah Green is one amazing player. She's a bounce back from Sonoma State from last year. There's two blocks for her.
Two blocks there by Hannah Green. Yeah, right there.
She's actually averaging 5 blocks per game on the season. And it, just in the last 5 games alone, she has 4.8 blocks per game in just the last 5 games.
Hannah Green out to Rojas, who shoots it and makes it. You got to watch out for Marina Rojas for the outside. She loves to take threes, and for a good reason. She makes them quite often. In comes Gray. She's going to kick it out. Three-pointer there. Mamusa Seca. You wouldn't expect that out of your center, but she can shoot it from out there. Rojas pushing the issue. Going to go in, going to go outside. Hannah Green.
Hannah Green, and misses again. She's not hitting it today so far. I think she's 0 for 3 right now.
Hannah Green getting some good looks, but not quite being able to knock him down. Gray going to go inside. Teardrop up. Just couldn't get it quite. A little bit long. Rojas with a cross-court pass out to Ward. It looks like it's going to be a timeout here.
Timeout from Coach Strong. She doesn't look too happy about that one. An outlet pass down the floor. 50-yard pass, it looked like.
Rojas over there to Aaron Kiley, who, you know, good job on both ends to keep her head up, but Corsairs were caught sleeping there.
Definitely were. They're going to have to keep their heads up all game long. They're going to want to keep this close early because the Canyons are going to want to try to run away with some early points and put this game away real early. Definitely watch the three-point shooting, especially with Monica Friedel off the floor. It looks like the College of the Canyons is running about a four-guard set with one center, the one center being Hannah Green. And watch Green to dominate the boards, especially if Mamusa Seca has been on the outside and isn't able to anchor the middle of the paint.
O'Shyla Gray stays in the game. She's a huge part of this Corsairs team. Up and in, inside, can't quite finish, is Keanu Evans. Rojas has the ball, pass, gets it right back, looks inside, ooh, right behind, ooh, what a beautiful pass right there from Sir Ward to Aaron Kiley. Kylie's going to shoot two. That was some beautiful ball movement right there by the Cougars.
Great ball movement. They're a team that can really move the ball around during the game. They're actually averaging 19 assists per game. Especially to Santa Monica's 10.7. So definitely look for them to pass the ball around, try to catch the defense shifting and try to move around. And especially with the Corsairs playing a full court trap, if they pass the ball well, the Cougars will be able to have some good easy buckets, a lot of layups, and be able to dominate the paint.
Now it looks like we have a technical issue over at the scores table. Coach Greg Herrick talking with the officials.
Yeah, the refereeing crew for tonight is actually, you're going to see Kenny Nash, Nicole Cijian, and Anthony Royal. So you're seeing the referees trying to take care of an issue over on the side.
You know, Herrick doesn't look like the happiest fellow over there right now, but, I mean, he should be. 5:03 left in this first. His team is up 10-5.
So while they're sorting out this issue, Kevin, what exactly do you think about this rain today?
I got to say, it's not the prettiest thing to go outside and see a pool full of water at your front doorstep. But luckily, we're inside, we're indoors, most importantly, we're dry. So, I mean, I don't mind the rain as long as we're in here watching this game.
I agree with that.
It's not often you get to see rain like this in Los Angeles. It's sort of funny to watch how people react. People go crazy when it rains here in LA.
It's been a drought. It looks like stoppage of play here to figure out the issue over at the scorer's table on both ends.
And by the way, for those joining us, this is your color commentator, Josh Scher, and I'm with my partner in crime right now, my play-by-play, Mr. Kevin Coe.
There you go.
It looks like they figured out whatever the problem was.
Let's get this game back going. Aaron Kiley is going to shoot two. Corsairs down six. Cougars 11-5 with 5:03 here left in the first. First free throw by Kiley is good. Now it looks like we got a new sub in here for the Corsairs.
Good.
New backcourt here with Chavez. It's Chavez in. Gray handling point guard duties. It looks like a double screen here up top. Let's see what the Corsairs want to do with this. Gray going to drive in. Gets blocked by and Hannah Green.
There's another block for Hannah Green. That looks like her third one of the night. Corsair, and there's number four.
Green trying to get another block. Offensive foul there.
She's just dominating the paint right now. If the Corsairs are going to look to score, it's not going to be down low. Hannah Green is going to stop them on every opportunity. They're going to have to try to start pulling up for some shots from the outside because Hannah Green is just one force to be reckoned with down low.
It looks like the Corsairs are going with the zone here. Probably to stop the inside, but remember, the Cougars can shoot, and that was evidence of it right there. Sierra O'Brien knocks down the three. Now the Corsairs, it looks like they're still going to go with that zone back on the defensive end, but that double screen up top again here on offense. Oh, great. They're really going to give her the keys to this offense. She takes the elbow jumper short. O'Brien made the three on the last possession, goes to the other end. Oh, a deflection by a Corsairs player, but it goes right into the hands of Aaron Kiley. Corsairs letting this one get away early. Gray drives in. It's going to be a travel. That's another turnover for the Corsairs. This one.
You can really see the versatility of the Cougars team right now. With Friedel sitting on the bench and Green not connecting on her first few shots. You've seen the Cougars go outside shooting three-pointers as well trying to find some backdoor cuts into the paint and are getting some easy buckets, very uncontested shots.
Rojas swings it to Kiley, who knocks down the jumper again. Aaron Kiley having a very solid game here. First quarter, mind you, 20-5 Cougars up in. Just missed the front of the rim. Keanu Evans is going to go to the line to shoot two.
Again, they're trying to go back after them and try to go after the paint. I guess Strong liked what she saw when she got Friedel in early foul trouble and is trying to see if she can draw some fouls and send her girls to the free throw line.
First free throw is good. Corsairs, 6th point of the first.
If I would take a guess here, I'm going to guess that Hannah Green is going to get the rebound if this is a miss right here.
Now, Hannah Green has been having a very solid game, making her presence felt on both sides of the floor. It looks like we are going to get a substitution here. Friedel, with those two fouls, is back in. Surprisingly, Green stays in with her. They're going to try to increase this lead here in the first. Rojas has the ball up top. She's been handling most of the ball handling duties for this offense. Swings it over to O'Brien.
Kiley gets
the ball knocked off. It's going to stay on this end of the court, however.
Watch the way the offense runs for the Cougars, running some off-ball screens with Hannah Green and Friedel, trying to clear up some room for some shooters.
Rojas to O'Brien. O'Brien's going to drive in. She's going to put it up. Green with the offensive rebound up and in.
Again, she's going to be attacking the glass. You're going to have to box her out, or else she's going to be a problem for you all night long.
It Chavez has the ball at top. She's going to shoot the three. It's short. And Green with a defensive rebound. Looks like it's going to be a jump ball.
That was a wonderful play there. Friedel actually wasn't able to go up and grab it with two hands and instead tipped it over to her her other tower down below and Hannah Green with the rebound.
Looks like it's going to stay on this end here.
Possession arrow will switch to the other side.
Pass outside to Evans. Evans going to go inside, put it up. No good. Another rebound for Hannah Green. Rojas swings it in. Friedel, bank shot, no good. Looks like it's going to be still stay on this end right here.
Especially early, Hannah Green and Friedel can neither find the bottom of the net. Both of them are about 0 for 3 each.
Erin Kelly kicks it out to Rojas. She's going to drive in. Pats to the right. Hannah Green is having a great game right now.
Kylie
another
again.
Jump shot for Erin Kylie.
She's now in double digits for points.
Kylie's really got the shot going here in the first now. 2:15 left. Cougars up 24-7.
She might be getting some more minutes after this game. That is Kylie. She's only averaging about 15 minutes per game, but she's definitely making an impression today.
There's the offense for the Corsairs right there. Chavez gets two. Corsairs still trying to get in double digits here in the first. Cougars on the other end.
They got it to Friedel.
Friedel. She's going to miss that, but it's going to be two shots for Friedel. Now, it looks like the Corsairs over on the defensive end, they've tried a little bit of everything to stop this Twin Towers.
They've been doing a great job so far of actually stopping Friedel and Green, but the problem is their defense is collapsing to the paint. They're looking for the rebounds. They're looking to stop the two Twin Towers, but the problem is they're leaving open on the three-point shot. You're having Kylie knocked down. You're having Erin Kylie being able to knock down a few three-pointers. You've seen Marina Rojas knock down a three. You're seeing them being able to score from deep as well. So the Cougars are very versatile, especially on offense.
For the Cougars, we have Rojas and O'Brien out. We have Martin in.
And the call on that play was Hera Green. It was an offensive violation, key violation. Stepped into the lane too early, so the bucket doesn't count.
Chandler swings it over to Gray, who gets it right back. Corsair's trying to work something around, swinging the ball, going in. It's Chandler who puts it up, doesn't quite get it. Offensive rebound grabbed and put back up by Evans.
That was a great play on the offensive boards.
24-11 Cougars with a little bit more than a minute here to go in the first.
Hannah Green's trying to post up down low, but they can't even get her the ball. Some great defense down there.
They got a zone completely trying to neutralize those Twin Towers that you were talking about. It still looks like Cougars are trying to get the ball inside. Friedel swings it. Going to look back inside. Kylie's. Oh, great pass. Couldn't finish, but as you were saying, great pass by Erin Kylie, who's having herself a game. Corsair's going to try to push the issue here.
Another block for Hannah Green.
Hannah Green.
That's four on the night.
It's fast break. It's up. It's missed. Looks like it's going to be a foul. Rebound was grabbed by O'Shaughnessy Gray.
And that'll be a foul on number 22, Tamara Smith, for the Cougars.
Now, I mean, you could say the Cougars are also, you know, running this fast break, but the Corsairs really trying to get that early offense.
Especially after this first quarter where it looks like the Corsairs might be down double digits heading into the second. Let's see if Coach Strong is going to make any adjustments, see if she can run the offense to be able to free up some jump shots, maybe some better looks from outside, because all of the inside looks are not looking good.
Gray's first free throw is no good. Both teams are in the bonus, so we will be shooting free throws.
Hannah Green's getting a little bit of time rest in just the first quarter alone at four blocks out there.
Hannah Green sits. Second free throw is good. 24-12 with a little bit more than 30 seconds here to go in the first.
Run it to Friedel.
Friedel's going to shoot it.
Can't
it's
find
be short.
The bottom of the net.
Friedel's been struggling here. It's good for the Corsairs to see if they can take advantage of that. Gray has the ball up top. She's going to swing it over. Flores is going to try to work something out here. Corsairs trying to get something going. Hayes, Evans, up. Can't quite get in there, but Gray's able to knock it out, but it's going to be Cougars' ball. Now there's 5 seconds left here in the first. Let's see if the Cougars can get something.
A last-second heave. two.
That's Friedel.
Friedel for
have
three.
To shoot it.
Oh, it's a little bit long. She has not had a good first quarter.
This first quarter, you can argue, not good for a lot of parties here. But luckily, we got a lot more basketball here tonight. After the first, your score 24-12, College of the Canyons Cougars over SMC.
And now you can see over on the west side of the court, the SMC cheer team. Not too bad.
Too shabby, if I wouldn't say myself.
I think actually pretty soon they might be going down to Orlando, if I recall correctly, after talking with the cheerleading coach. They're supposed to be competing at Nationals down in at Disney World in Orlando, Florida pretty soon.
Great, solid cheer program we have here over at Santa Monica College. Now, after the first quarter, we were just talking about it, Josh. A little bit, you can look at this in multiple ways. One, Friedel. Arguably the Canyon's best player is in foul trouble, but on the Corsairs end, not a lot of great things to really talk about.
I actually sort of disagree. I think going into this game, Coach Strong had wanted to keep Friedel and Green off the scoreboard, and she's done so. Neither one are actually registering any field goals so far. Mm-hmm. But the problems are they're solely focusing on keeping Green and Friedel off the scoreboard. They're leaving other shooters from outside open and allowing them to be able to hit three-pointers and add to the score. And the Cougars are taking those chances and converting on them. I'd keep with the same strategy because, as we all know, everyone can't be Golden State Warriors and make all your three-pointers.
That is true. Here we're going to start the second quarter, 24-12 Cougars. Ball inside. Ward.
That
is going to be a travel. Now, there we go. Corsairs being able to force the turnover to start this quarter. Maybe we're going to see a different tune for the rest of these minutes.
The big issue for the Corsairs right now is that they're going to have to convert on offense. They're having stops on defense. They're keeping the big twin towers of the Cougars off the offensive glass, but they need to start scoring.
Looks like Coach Strong is going to keep Chandler and Gray both in the game. Flores stays in as well. She's had the ball up top while really Gray tries to run off these screens here. Speaking of Gray, she's going to get the ball up top. Thought about taking the three there in. Kick out. Flores up. Does not quite get it. Offensive rebound
Another
there.
Another offensive board, and it's in.
That's two offensive boards right there by Robin Ashkenazi.
That's actually her third one of the game so far. That's her second bucket. She's doing some work on the offensive glass.
She grabs another rebound right there. Gray going to push the tempo up, up.
With the left and another offensive board for Robin Ashkenazi. And fouled and go into the line.
Ashkenazi.
I think Coach Strong is finding her new post player.
Kiana Evans pumped up, giving some dab over there to Ashkenazi. Now, she is listed as one of the only two centers on this Corsairs team from Beverly Hills High School. She's going to get two free throws here. First one up, short.
Well, she's actually one of two players on the SMC Corsairs team that is from Beverly Hills High School. Her other former high school teammate, Jessica Malamed, who was the starting point guard on the team, just recently went down with an ACL tear just a few weeks ago, and will have surgery this upcoming Friday.
Now it looks like Hannah Green is in, and she grabs a rebound right away. Up at the other end, teardrop. Looks like it's going to be a jump ball there. Brittany Martin had the teardrop, tried to put it in, grabbed her own offensive rebound, but the ball is going to go the other way. Corsair's ball right here.
Well, back to Ashkenazi's former high school teammate, Malamed. She's supposed to have surgery this upcoming Friday for an ACL tear. And boy, was that one horrific injury. Watching someone on the ground screaming and in pain like that is never a sight anyone wants to see, especially here at basketball.
Hopefully the Corsairs can play four in a sense maybe and come out with a victory here. Looks like it's going to be a foul on number 13, Ward.
Looks like that'll actually be her second foul as well.
Cougars do have the lead, but they are in a bit of foul trouble here.
It's actually her third foul, so there's a little bit of foul trouble going on for the Cougars.
Evans puts the ball up, but gets it blocked by Green.
That's number five for her on the game.
Hannah Green really making her presence felt in there. If her or Friedel are in the game, you got to watch out for those blocks. Inside.
There's number six and seven. Nope. Ooh. And there's actually a foul on Green.
You know, the game is really at this point where it's not too far off for the Corsairs to come back right here. And what's really keeping them in is these offensive rebounds.
It is. They're winning the battle on the boards. Especially after talking with Coach Strong before the game, they needed to win this battle if they want to stay close. But foul trouble for the Cougars is not looking good for them. You're going to see some of their post players having to sit down a little bit longer, especially if they're going to be picking up these fouls.
Looks like Flores out, Seca in.
Corsairs are going to have to convert on some of these free throws.
Second free throw in and out, just like the first. Heartbreaker right there. Looks like we have O'Brien back in the game. Three-pointer up top. It's up, and it's good. Vicky Martinez puts the Cougars up 12. Oh, Seca wasn't able to stay up there. Looks like fast break coming. Great steal right there by Gray. She's going to run at the other end. She's going to go up with it. And one. Give it to Shyla Gray. She's going to go to the line.
And it looks like Green was called on the foul. So Green might have to sit down pretty soon because it looks like she is in foul trouble as well. So I guess Strong had a pretty good approach coming into the game. She wants to attack those big bodies in the paint for the Cougars, put them in foul trouble early. But now they actually have to make some stops on the defensive side. They can't leave open some shooters on the three-point side or long twos like was just hit. They need to start converting.
Aaron Kiley out, Ramon in for the Cougars. It looks like Friedel is going to come back in as well for Sarah Ward.
Let's see if she can register some points or if the Corsairs can keep her off the board through the entirety of the first half.
Santa Monica down just by nine. Finally got it to single digits here in the second quarter. Looks like we have a game on our hands here, folks. Pass up top.
There's some good tight defense. Friedel gets an opening.
Friedel hasn't been able to knock those down, but she has been able to get to the line. She has been able to get those rebounds. She's going to shoot two free throws right here. Now Friedel, as was just stated, she's getting some good looks, but she's not really knocking them down like we really expected her to. Not to a player of her caliber, I guess. Is that the Corsairs doing a good job of keeping her under pressure? Do you think she's just off?
I think she's a little bit off tonight. Especially with the two fouls, I think it's getting into her head a little bit. Every time she's missing, she's feeling like she can't make the shot.
Maybe that free throw right there will boost her confidence and get her going on the right track again. Gray, swing pass.
And there's the Twin Towers,
the Twin Towers, Green and Friedel. Green on the left side, but it looks like O'Brien tripped over the ball, it looks like.
And O'Shayla Gray with another steal.
O'Shayla Gray really keeping this team, you could say, in this game. Oh, that was a thing of beauty by O'Shayla Gray.
She put the Cougar player straight into the spinorama.
That got the bench up off their seats now. Cougar's trying to get a
Monica Friedel
the
with them.
Friedel going to go up. She's going to get fouled. It looks like the foul is going to be on O'Shayla Gray.
It's actually not a foul. They give her a block on that one. Out of bounds. Knock the ball loose.
The defensive wizard tonight, O'Shayla Gray.
They're going to have to stop Friedel on the boards, but especially with some momentum favoring the Corsairs right now, let's see if they can capitalize on this, knock down some buckets, and make some stops.
Inside.
And there's another steal for O'Shayla Gray. She's putting her team on her back.
O'Shayla Gray, swing pass.
And that's the meaning
Chandler
of determination.
Jump shot up. It's too long. Almost got the offensive rebound there.
There's
Talking
another.
About Ashkenazi.
There's another board for Green.
Three-pointer up. No good there by Vicky Martinez. Corsair is going to be at the other end. It's still a single-digit game, folks. Cougars only up nine with 6:30 here to go in the second.
Seca with the three.
She tries to make her second one there. Wasn't quite there. Cougar's going to try to run down the other end. O'Brien, swing pass. Martinez looks inside to Green. Up. It's no good, but the foul. Hannah Green going to shoot some free throws. Now, she was knocking down those shots, ladies and gentlemen, from the elbow consistently over there.
Yeah, especially watching her in warm-ups just knock down shot after shot after shot. It's very surprising to see that she's not able to knock down one shot yet so far this game. But let's hope that her being sent to the free throw line might actually be able to get her out of her groove and be able to start converting with some more shots.
First free throw is good. 29-19, back to a double-digit game. Cougars up by 10. 6:06 here left in the second quarter.
Few substitutes for the Corsairs. Took out Robin Ashkenazi, who was eating it up on the boards. Had four offensive boards so far today.
Looks like Rojas is also back in. She has that three-point stroke. She was taking him in the first. We'll see what happens. And, of course, Aaron Kiley, who was just having shooting lights out, really, in the first quarter. The second free throw.
No good. And there's the offensive board for the Cougars.
Aaron Kiley gets that offensive board. Friedel up.
Misses.
Hannah Green
up again.
Nope.
Misses.
Offensive rebound is not secured. Let's see the call. It's going to be a jump ball. Possession Cougars.
Well, we were here watching the entirety of practice. I never saw anyone go up there and put a lid on the basket, but it seems like neither Friedel or Green could be able to convert anything right now.
Ball out to Friedel. She's going to go inside. She lost it. It went off her thigh. Oh, but they're going to call it at the other end. It's going to stay on this side. Aaron Kiley.
This is a long possession for the Cougars. Let's hope the Corsairs can get a stop here and use the momentum to go down and score.
Friedel finally gets one to go in. That's going to put 31-19, 12-point game here.
You're going to have to come back and score.
Try to go inside here. Blocked by Hannah Green. They're going to call the late foul. One person that definitely does not agree with that is Hannah Green there.
She is not happy. That's foul number three on her, and that's another player with three fouls for the Cougars.
And
if you can see the coach right now for the Canyons, he's giving a little bit of lip right now with the referees.
Mamusa Seka, first free throw is good. Seka's really been having to go to work down low against Green and both Friedel throughout this game. Been doing a good job of keeping it together and really keeping this game close. It's a 10-point game. Rojas brings the ball up. Looking for something. O'Brien back to Friedel, who's going to go inside. No good. Friedel gets her own rebound, puts it up, gets her own shot again, and it's good. Friedel, offensive rebound after offensive rebound.
And she's now starting to score, so this is something you do not want to see if you're a Corsair fan.
Gray going to pull up for the shot.
She's starting to find it.
Fast break here. O'Brien to Kiley. She's going to give it to Green. Who's going to go in? Lay it up. It's short.
Green is not happy coming down the floor. She cannot find any of her shots.
Corsair's trying to get something on the other end.
And there's another block for Hannah Green. That's number six on in the night.
Roberta Hayes just couldn't get it to go there.
Friedel with the... And she's
shot.
Now trying to find it. That's three straight shots for her. If I was strong, I'm going to be having to put someone on her for the rest of the game because you're not going to want to see Friedel putting it in.
Chandler gets blocked by guess who?
That's Hannah Green.
There we go.
And that's number seven on the night for Hannah Green. And it's still the first half. Seven blocks in the first half for Hannah Green.
It's a block party here, folks. It's a block party here for Hannah Green.
I guess for all the shots she can't get to go down, she's contributing on the defensive end. She's one real big hustle player for that team. Offensive boards and blocks is her thing.
35-21, Cougars. Chavez in, Chandler out.
Mamusa Seka with the layup. That's a great inbounds play. Mamusa Seka is having a great game today.
I don't think Gray has actually been out of this game yet. That's how important she really is to the squad right now. Shot up in, good by Sarah Ward. 37-23. Cougars with 4:10 here.
Look for the Corsairs.
Look, Friedel gets the steal. She's going to go up. And it's no good. But
it's a charge. That is going to be foul number three, if not maybe foul number four on Friedel.
see if Greg Herrick here.
That's third personal. So if you look at the three post players for the Cougars, Hannah Green, Monica Friedel, as well as Sarah Ward, all three of them have three personal fouls, and it's only the first half with just under 4 minutes left.
Looks like head coach Greg Herrick is not worrying too much about it. He's not going to switch anyone out. It looks like he's going to let them play.
O'Shea Gray does it herself with the layup.
Brittany Martin brings it all the way up, and it looks like up and in again. Erin Kiley.
She's the one offensively leading the Cougars at the moment.
Almost throwing against Saseka. Runs into a body there. It looks like it's just going to stay here on the Corsairs' side of the court.
Watch Coach Strong look to go right back after them in the paint, especially with the two post players for the Cougars with three fouls each. Look to try to draw a fourth foul from one of them and make them have to sit.
Evans inbounds out to a shot that is short by Hayes. Cougars gonna go for the three here. It's short. O'Brien couldn't quite get it to go. We're gonna have a jump ball here. It's Gray and it's Friedel.
Monica Friedel with an offensive board. Coach Strong's not going to be too happy about watching her players give up offensive boards like that. They need to be able to make some stops. They need to grab the boards. They need to be able to come down and score.
O'Shiley Gray called for the push off. It's going the other way. Cougars ball, 3:08 here, left in the half. 39-25 Cougars.
Looks like Hannah Green's coming in for Sarah Ward. Hannah Green coming in with three fouls, getting a little bit of her break on the sideline.
Was that seven blocks, you said?
Seven blocks.
Seven blocks
so far in the first half. And we still got 3 minutes to go in the.
Friedel on the left side, looking for somewhere to get the ball to.
Friedel to Kiley.
Aaron Kiley up top.
Kiley to O'Brien. O'Brien
it's
loses gonna
the
ball.
It's going to be a steal by Chavez. They're going to rub it up and in. Gray handling the ball. Pass back to Chavez. Going to have the ball up. Shoots the three. It's short. Ball's going to go the other way. Hannah Green will inbound. Look good. Brittany Martin going to bring the ball up the court. Oh, look at that steal by
Saseka.
She's going to go up. It's going to go in. Fast break points there for Mamusa Seka. Corsairs down 12.
Mamusa Seka already reaching, 9 points so far in the game. She's already passed her average of 7.6 points per game. She's coming off a good game.
Friedel called for the travel there. Gonna go the other way. Corsairs ball. 2:16 left here. Let's see if Coach Strong can get her team to get going here, get some momentum going into the half.
Well, if I was Coach Strong, I'd be sort of happy with my play so far this half.
Gray up top, takes the jumper. It's short.
Rebound by Erin Kiley.
Erin Kiley gonna bring the ball up herself. Brings it back up to Martin. Looking. Smith passes to Kiley again. Jab step right there. Friedel up top. Looks like they're going to go Kiley inside. No, Green up top. Green has the ball up at the top of the key. She's going to shoot the mid-range. It's going to be short. Corsairs trying to run a bit of a fast break. Chavez has the ball.
I think the rain might be getting to Hannah Green because she is ice cold today.
That shot is short.
Hannah Green keeps on trying to put up shots on the offensive half, but she cannot make anything. She's made, I think, one, maybe two free throws, but she can't hit anything from the floor. It might be the rain that's getting to her. She is ice cold today.
She might have even used up all of her shots pregame because she was knocking those down.
Yeah, she was, especially in pregame watching her, it was like, wow, how are you going to stop her? And the Corsairs were up for the task and have done a great job of it. But they're going to see how they're going to have to find a way to try to avoid her, at least when they're on the offensive half, because Hannah Green is just blocking everything that comes through the paint.
1:29 here left in the first half. 39-27 Cougars. Out of the timeout. Corsairs will have the ball.
I'd say look out for a play where the first person that gets the ball here is going to go straight to shoot. Can't find their
ball
target.
Ball goes out to Gray. When all goes wrong, give the ball to Oshayla Gray. Feel like that is the motto here. Oh, tries to go for the fake. Hannah Green was not falling for that at all.
And that's number 8. She's nearly in double digits for blocks alone.
Pass. Friedel.
Friedel
it's
with
up.
The bucket. That's
it's
number.
Good.
That's her 4th field goal of the game. You do not want to see her get going if you're the Corsairs.
Gray going to bring the ball up. She's going to try to get something going. Jump shot is short again. Hannah Green with yet another rebound. Going to give the ball. Martin. Looks like it's going to be, it's going to stay here. Out of bounds on a Corsairs player. Erin Kiley will be inbounding.
And especially of recently, Hannah Green has been eating up the boards. In the last 5 games for the 5 wins for the Canyons, she has been averaging, and I'm not stuttering here, 16.2 rebounds per game.
Call it an okey-doke here, folks. They switch the call. You don't see officials doing that quite too often, but great of them to call on their honest mistake. Gray going to have the ball up top. Mid-range shot over Green is almost in. Can't quite get the shooter's touch. Ball up top. Ooh, it's going to go up. It's going to go in. That was some nice passing there by the Corsairs.
Green tapping the ball over to Erin Kiley.
Evans couldn't quite finish it, though. Trying to get a quick shot on the other end is the Cougars. Shot is way off by Smith, but she's going to get 2.
And I got a stat line for you to think about. Last game for the College of the Canyons against L.A. Mission, Hannah Green had 21 points, 27 rebounds,
wow.
8 offensive boards, and 5 blocks.
Now, at this point of the game, other than the 5 blocks, because we passed that, Josh, I would not be surprised to see something like that here tonight.
I'd definitely look to maybe see her put up about 20 rebounds, but I don't know about the points. She's not been able to find anything so far.
43-27 with 20 seconds left here in the first half.
But it looks like the Cougars don't need Hannah Green to score at all, especially with a 16-point lead at the closing seconds of the first half.
Oshayla Gray trying to get something going up top.
Find Chavez.
It's Chavez.
3 is no good, and another rebound for Hannah Green.
Hannah Green, full court shot. It's no good. And at the half, 43-27 Cougars. Now, Lydia Strong does not look like the happiest camper over there. I'm sure she'll have a lot to say to the Lady Corsairs as we head into halftime.
Defensively, I think the Corsairs did exactly what they wanted to do. But I think offensively, they need to find the bottom of the basket a little bit more. They need to make their free throws. They need to be able to shoot, make something from the outside to be able to shoot. Because everything they bring inside was getting blocked by Hannah Green. I guess you could say their lone stars on offense were Robin Ashkenazi on the offensive glass with a few putbacks, as well as Mumu Saseka.
Story of the first half here, Friedel, Green, absolutely dominating, even with the foul trouble, even with the inability to consistently make their field goals. They're getting it done with the free throws. They're getting it done with the rebounds. Hannah Green is getting it done on the defensive end. It looks like a lot of what we thought is going to be happening here before the game, but of course they're sticking in there.
They are sticking in there. They do have a sort of a shallow roster. They only have 9 available girls at the moment, even though they started the season with 13. They've had an issue with one of their players who's sort of been dismissed from the team due to some scholastic issues. I talked about earlier about Jessica Malamed, point guard, who went down with an ACL tear, absolutely horrific injury, and who's having surgery soon. But one that's very unusual for the team is the SMC Corsairs actually lost 2 of their players after the first night of their first home game. That would be freshman Akayla Brown, as well as freshman Vanessa Zamora, both of which were actually in a very bad car accident. And both of them have sustained season-ending injuries from the accident. And we'll have to be on the sidelines for the rest of the season. It's absolutely tragic. To have two girls that have such a bright future ahead of them have to be sidelined with injuries from an accident.
Our hearts go out to those players, of course.
Let's hope they get better and can be back on the court sometime soon.
Now, we were talking about Lydia Strong not looking like the happiest camper, but it looks like she is grateful enough to give us this halftime interview. Let's see what she thinks about her team's first half performance. Down with Coach Strong is Kelly Tittle.
I'm standing here with Coach Strong. What do you hope to do? What do you hope to implement going into the second half to put more points up onto the board?
We got to shoot better. We were, I think, 9 of 43 from the field. We just didn't shoot well at all. So we've got to get better shots, and we got to make them. I think they're kind of afraid to get blocked inside, so we're missing a lot. But I think we'll be okay if we start making shots and not worried about getting hit.
Okay. Thank you so much. Good luck with the second half.
Thank you.
And here we are for the second half between the Cougars and the Corsairs. Cougars are leading the Corsairs 46-27 at halftime. Let's see the Cougars this next half. Going to try to feed the ball into Friedel and Green a little bit more, see if Green can actually make some field goals. Lid's been on the basket for her. Let's see if the Corsairs can start converting on offense and make this a closer game, or if the Cougars are going to run away with this.
As Josh just eloquently stated, second half here is underway. Cougars are going to try to build that lead, and Corsairs are going to try to come back in this one.
Green finally gets her first basket of the game. You see that big clap from her.
Now, Hannah Green, she was knocking those down pregame over and over and over. She's going to try to get it going here in the second.
Second of Hayes. Corsair, Hayes can't convert.
Corsairs go right at the Twin Towers right there. I try to go inside, just not quite there. Maybe that's a tale of the second half here for the Cougars, for the Corsairs. Friedel goes up off the back iron. Rebound there secured by Hayes. Gray on the left side of the court. She was a huge part of the Corsairs offense in the first. Running teardrop, no good, but foul. Looks like the foul is going to be on Marina Rojas. Two shots coming up for Gray.
Well, Shayla Gray, Miss Do It Herself, she's been pretty much the lone star for the Corsairs this season. She's been very consistent. She's averaging 16.5 points per game, averaging 4.5 rebounds per game. She's averaging 4.5 assists per game. So look for her to be able to try to take over the second half and try to bring them back if there's any chance for the Corsairs.
Oh, Shyla Gray knocked down the first. Second one is good. Cougars 45-29 with about 9 minutes here
and if the,
left.
And if the Corsairs want any success, they're going to have to keep Green and Friedel back off the points and off the scoreboard, or else it's going to be a long second half.
Rojas and O'Brien running that two game. It's a quick backcourt that the Corsairs have had to accommodate. Looks like a Chavez and Gray have been doing a good job of locking them down for this possession.
Aaron Kylie and Hannah Green.
Inside to Green, who's going to spin, put it up. She's fouled. She's pumped. She's clapping. And she's going to the line for two free throws.
It makes it very interesting with the Cougars having two amazing post players like Hannah Green and Friedel. Especially after Friedel had a great season last year and earned some amazing accolades. They had the luxury of having someone like Hannah Green, who bounced back from Sonoma State to now play for the College of the Canyons.
Now, when we talk about Hannah Green and Friedel, we do talk about them as being bigs, but they kind of don't remind you of the typical big in the sense that they can shoot. The handles aren't bad, but they can definitely both knock down that jump shot.
They both love the elbow jump shot. Hannah Green likes it a little bit more up around the free throw line, while Friedel likes it off to the side and likes to use almost like the Tim Duncan bank.
Hayes tried to go with the up and under. Rojas gets it on the other end.
With
no look
pass to
Friedel, who just can't finish. Gray going to try to do something herself on the other end. Goes up. Goes no good.
Coast to coast,
Hannah
but
Green
no score.
With the rebound, Rojas going to push it again. Another pass to Friedel. Let's see if she can finish it this time. Give the assist to Rojas. Another 2 points for the Cougars.
Some
20
flashy,
point lead here.
That's some flashy passing from Rojas. And if you see that there, a little bit of what you saw in the first half, a little bit more in the second now. And that's Hannah Green with yet another block. That is 9 on the game. She's actually now tied her second most on the season She was actually able to register 12 blocks in one game earlier this season, so let's see if she can match that number or be able to exceed it.
Hayes thought about it for a second, but she's going to give it up to Seca, who knocks down the three. That's her second one of the game for the Corsair Center.
Mimusa Seca, the 6'2" center out of Stockholm, Sweden. That's her second three. She's converting on offense. Her and O'Shea LeGray are the two lone stars right now.
Speaking of Seca, the lone star, she gets the steal, unable to finish on the other end. Not used to seeing your center run the fast break per se, but she did get the steal, but she also gets the turnover.
Last time she ran the fast break, she was able to convert, but she lost the handles there, especially with Rojas tracking her down.
Rojas up top, going to get the screen from Green, who's going to roll, but Rojas is going to take it up herself, and it's good. Marina Rojas goes inside. We haven't seen too much of that, but maybe we will this half. But what we've seen have, again, O'Shea Gray putting the team on her back. Rojas, swing pass to O'Brien, going to get it back up top.
Friedel trying to find it in the green.
Friedel going to go inside. Worked that two-man game with Green. Didn't work out that time, but I wouldn't be surprised to see Friedel and Green work a little two-man game in this half.
Yeah, trying to do a little bit too much. Friedel tried to do a little bit of a spin move, a little bit of a no-look pass. And especially when everything's not really connecting much and when a team is as suffocating as the Corsairs have been on defense, it's not easy to get the ball into the post.
O'Shea Gray has the ball up top. She's going to kick it to Hayes on the left side. Hayes going to get the screen inside. They're trying to get it to Ashkenazi.
There's number 10. Double digits now for Hannah Green on blocks.
We've hit the double digit mark, folks. It's officially a block party here for Hannah Green. Hayes going to go inside. Going to try to put it up. Give her 11. She's got 11 blocks. Hannah Green. Saying she's active on the defensive end would be a bit of an understatement. Looks like it's going to be ball out of bounds. It's going to stay here with the Cougars.
Well, I guess Hannah Green must have sent some invitations over to SMC before today because she has the block party going.
Friedel gets the ball up top, finds Aaron Kylie inside, but nope, it's going to be an offensive foul.
Looked like they called a moving screen on that on the backdoor cut. Tried to free up Aaron Kylie with a pass from Monica Friedel, but number five, Sarah O'Brien, was called with a moving screen, and that'll be her second personal foul.
Hayes gives it to Gray, who O'Shea Gray. Usage rate has been high in this one for Gray, but it has been like that the entire season. Tries to get past O'Brien up there. O'Brien staying in front of her. O'Shea Gray, crossover. Gives it out. Echevez to the right side. Looks like they're going to call the foul on O'Brien. A little too much contact in there. Ball will be inbounded by the Corsairs. Echevez will inbound.
And that'll actually be your third personal on O'Brien as well. So that's three for O'Brien, three for Friedel, three for Green, three for Ward. A lot of fouls.
Gray got the screen in Ashkenazi. Hayes is going to put it up, but get it blocked.
And that's number 12 by Hannah Green. That she's just tied her season season high in blocks so far this game.
We need to get a Hannah Green block meter or something, like just record all of these blocks that she's getting, because she's just got, she might have got
another
13.
One. I don't know if they're going to count that one, but that looked
Echevez.
Like number 13.
That was a great drive by Echevez, switching the hands there to her left. Couldn't quite get it to go. Rojas doing an excellent job of running the fast break. Ends up with an Aaron Kylie lay-in. That was Rojas to Friedel to Kylie. And just like that, 53-34 Cougars.
They're starting to run away with it with a 19-point lead right now.
Let's see if the Corsairs can get something on this end of the court. Looks like it's going to go...
It looks like defensive... No... Offensive 3 second call.
It's going the other way here, folks. Ashkenazi out for the Corsairs. Seca in.
Well, Kevin, if you ever watch baseball at all, you know how they have the K's for strikeouts. We're going to need something like that for Hannah Green because that's 12, if not 13 blocks on the game.
Yeah.
But wow.
Rojas goes in hard, gets fouled, possibly even harder. Foul is going to be on number 10, Kiana Evans.
Hannah Green is just one special player. She can't make it on the offensive half. She hasn't been able to score much, but she's able to do it on the defensive half. She's eating it up on the boards, grabbing everything on the glass. And then every time something goes up in the post, expect her to be right there with the Corsair players.
Caitlin Flores in, Hayes out for the Corsairs. Let's see if this second free throw can go in for Rojas. And it's up. It's good. 20-point lead here for the Cougars. Gray gonna bring the ball up. Up top, she's guarded by Tamara Smith. Ball inside, up and in. It's fumbled. It looks like it's going to be out of bounds on Kiana Evans.
It was fumbled out of bounds, but you obviously know who was there defending her and forced the turnover.
Rojas gonna swing it. Tamara Smith looking for someone. Erin Kiley thought about the shot. Friedel back to Smith.
Off ball looking. Screens, finds Hannah
finds Green.
Green.
Hannah Green does the crossover. I thought she was going to shoot that one. Rojas going into her right. She's looking. She tries going into Friedel. Good defense there and awareness by Evans. Knocks the ball out, but it's going to stay on this side of the court. Keep a look at that shot clock, folks. Only 9 seconds left for this possession. Wide open shot for Smith. She gets blocked there by Echeves. Great defense there by the Corsairs. Let's see if they can capitalize on the other side. Echeves, who just got that block on the other end, she's going to go in. She's going to give it out to Hayes. Who's going to give it back out to Gray? Well, Charlotte Gray going to try to calm things down here for the Corsairs, get some offense running. She's going to go in. She's going to go to her left, weaving, running around, gets it inside. Ball up, fake, off the back. Not quite there for the Corsairs. Kiana Evans just quite hasn't been able to get it in there. Rojas bounced past the Green. Who's going to shoot it? I think she was expecting the foul call there.
Looked like a little bit of a tip by Mamusu Seka there and got the block.
You know, the refs are letting them play. Coaches may be a bit going insane on the sidelines, but this is some back and forth basketball we're getting here, folks. Timeout here on by the Corsairs. Coach Lydia Strong wants to talk it over with her team. 54-34. Timeout Corsairs. There's 3:30 here left in the quarter.
Well, the Corsairs are sticking around with around down 19. They can't really close the margin much. They're not converting on the offensive half. You've seen them still try to feed the ball down low, which isn't working. Let's see if Strong can make some adjustments. She hasn't been able to make many adjustments yet. I don't know if she can trust her outside shooting because it hasn't really been working much tonight. So let's see what she's going to do and how she's going to handle this deficit at the moment and see if she can trim the deficit.
Oh, Shiloh Gray went back to talk with Lydia Strong. I thought they were going to discuss something. No. Gray getting a drink of water. That's how much she's been playing this game, folks. She's been playing minutes on minutes on minutes. Now it's going to be ball again to the Cougars. Erin Kiley going to be the inbounder. Triple screen up top for Smith, who can't knock it down, but that was a pretty play there by the Cougars to set up the shooter. Oh, nice pass inside. Give the assist to Chavez.
Mamusa
give the bucket Sega to Mamusa. As you were saying, Mamusa.
Mamusa Seca has been Smith scoring all night long.
Green tries to hook that in.
And that's her first field goal of the night. That's something, again, you don't want to see if you're Coach Strong. You don't want to see Green start scoring points. You saw Friedel have a little bit earlier at the end of the first half, but you don't want to see Green start to score.
It looks like we got a little something going here with Mamusu Seka. That's her second straight bucket.
There's a steal by Echeves,
who's having a great defensive game. Gray
Shala
up, and it's good. Corsairs, they got a little something going here, folks. 56-40, 2:25 left in the quarter. Rojas.
Best offense is a good defense, and those are that's some good defense by the Corsairs.
Inside to Green. Rojas gets it right back. It launches the three. It's short.
Mamusa Seka all over the floor right now. She's had steals. She's had some blocks. She's scoring. Has come down and scored two times in a row. We're looking around about 15 points so far tonight, and she's grabbing the boards.
Oshyla Gray up top trying to get this offense.
Look for them to go after
up
Seka.
And running. looked for Sheka. They're going to get the three from Echevez. No good.
She hasn't been able to convert it on that from downtown at all yet tonight.
Rojas guarded by Echevez, who has a couple of good defensive possessions here.
Trying to feed Green. Can't get Friedel. It anywhere.
Up top, Green gets it. Friedel again shoots the jumper. That's blocked
by Sheka.
Sheka with the, she blocks it. Good defense on the second try bear by Friedel. Corsairs on the other end. Echevez, no good.
That was 1-on-3 right there.
Rojas brings it to the other end. Smith, crossover, goes down the middle, up. Not quite able to get the ball in there.
Oh, Shayla do it herself, Gray with the rebound.
Shayla Gray brings it up, goes to her left, crossover. Welcome back outside. Echevez gonna try another one, that's short. Looks like the ball will go to the College of the Canyon Cougars. Now we got a lot of substitutions here coming in for the College of the Canyons. Rojas out, Smith out, Friedel out.
Well, the thing is, the Corsairs are showing a few glimpses of being able to score some buckets and trim the deficit, but it's far and few between, especially against a great Cougars team right now. They're really going to have to pick it up, at least with 11 minutes left in this game. They're really going to have to find something if they're going to want to look for a W on the score at the end of the game.
Shot is up and in by Sarah Ward. She made a couple buckets in this game. She's having a nice game off the bench. Up top, we got some subs here by the Corsairs as well. And speaking of them, Ashkenazi gets the assist from Chandler.
And it looks like O'Shayla Gray got a little bit of a rest at the end of the third quarter. They might want to use her for all 10 minutes of the fourth. So they're going to want to keep her nice and rested.
O'Shayla Gray not playing now. That's something I didn't expect to see here tonight. Looks like the ball is going to go the other way. Corsairs ball.
And if you're... and it, the Cougars coach is not too happy right now after that one. It looks like Hannah Green has just picked up her fourth personal foul.
Chandler gives it to Sheka, who's going to be called for the travel. Turnover there by Mamusa Sheka, who has been having a good quarter here. Has some blocks, some buckets.
Some rebounds, some steals.
Huge part of this this mini comeback that the Corsairs have staged. Not quite there yet, though. Hannah Green going to try to shoot over like two people, and no good. Difficult shot there by Hannah Green, but if anyone knows, she can definitely knock it down. Full court heave there by Flores is no good. And at the end of three, we have the College of the Canyon Cougars up 58-42. We got one more quarter here. What do you have left here for the fourth, Josh?
I think the Corsairs are going to have to try to go after Hannah Green. Maybe see if they can get another foul on her and maybe knock her out of the game. She has maybe 12, maybe 13. We're not quite certain, but she's has a block party going.
Now is it? There's 10 minutes left in this last quarter here. Is it time for the Corsairs to maybe push the tempo, shoot some threes, like antsy up the threes, or do they still have time to run your offense efficiently?
They need to go back to what they started the game with. They need a full court press. They need to look for some turnovers. They need some easy buckets here because it's not easy when they get the offense going. When the defense gets to set up for the Cougars, the Corsairs keep on trying to feed the ball to the post, and Hannah Green has been there every single time for a block.
Looks
so
like
you're gonna have to go full court press, look for the steal. If you can't get the steal, get ready to turn around and grab a board because you're gonna have to be able to try to come back in this game and put some points on the board quick.
Looks like we're set to go here in the fourth. Corsairs will come out with Echevez, O'Brien, excuse me, Chandler, who has the ball up top. Gonna give it, tried to give it to Sheka. She's on the right side asking for the ball. But it looks like Chandler's going to try to run things on her own here. Mid-range shot, almost went for it. Back inside to Sheka, who wanted that ball, and she cannot finish. Ball's going to go the other way. Cougars ball.
It's surprising to see someone be able to get up a shot, especially when being guarded by Hannah Green. It seems like every time someone puts something up on her, she's been blocking it.
Echevez playing those passing lanes very well. She's trying to get this steal. Corsairs are going to have to force the issue a little bit and get some turnovers if they want to come back in this game.
You can see their pressure on ball is a little bit tighter. They're looking for some steals right now. They're looking to try to be able to come down and get something. Hannah Green.
Hannah Green triple teamed right there. Sarah Ward's jump shot is no good, but the rebound goes to Brittany Martin, whose layup is no good. Corsairs going to try to run. Echeves has a 1-on-5. She tries to get it in to Seca, but the defensive juggernaut. Hannah Green is right there to get it. Pushing the issue on the other end is Martin. Lays it up, it's good. 60-42 with 8:50 left here. Cougars up over the Corsairs. Chandler goes in and one. Now we needed something here from the Corsairs here, folks. Let's see if Michaela Chandler can get that going. She's a freshman guard out of Minneapolis, and she's going to try to convert the and one.
Well, the thing is, Kevin, they're really going to have to make some stops here. You can't let them have the offensive boards and be able to have second chance points, especially with a team like Canyons that puts the points on the board very quickly and can. You have to keep them off the board, and you need SMC to start scoring some buckets and buckets and bunches.
Brittany Martin with the ball up top. Inside to Hannah Green, who has the ball. Middle of the free throw line. Martinez over to Riley. Going to look inside. Come back out to Green. He's going to crossover.
Oh, with the crossover.
And no good. But those were some nice moves over there by Hannah Green.
Well, if I was a Corsair defender there, I'd have to check my ankles after that one because it looked like someone might have had their ankles broken.
We've had block parties, ankle insurance. Hannah Green, really an impressive outing here for the Cougars. A huge part of the reason why they're up 15 right now with 8:09 left in this one. First free throw is no good.
Well, one thing for certain that she hasn't been able to do much of is get on the scoreboard and put some points on the board. But I guess the Cougars don't necessarily need to ask her of that. They don't need her to score a lot of points because she can do everything else.
Evans comes in for Flores. We also have Green out, Friedel in. 8:20 left here, 61-45 Cougars. Up top is Chandler trying to run things. Interesting not to see Gray here. We haven't seen too much of the Corsairs without Oshyla Gray.
And there's an unforced error right there. Turning over the ball, not a lot of tough pressure, just a misplaced pass, and Canyons gets the ball back.
Brittany Martin goes through the trees, lays it up and in.
Going with the left hand. You saw her working on that in practice going up against Friedel.
Chandler going in, trying to do just what happened on the other end. Can't quite finish.
On the fast break.
Looks in, up. That's a block.
Mimosa.
Sarah Ward just couldn't quite get that pass. Mimosa. Seca, who's actually going to get the ball back, almost finished on the other end. Rewarding the big man there for running the floor, but she couldn't quite finish. Friedel, she's going to be fouled by Seca. It looks like Friedel, who was in a bit of foul trouble, you could say, in the first. She's doing a good job of not getting called for too many fouls. She finally gets the other end of it and gets something called for her. Let's see.
Look at them go after Monica Friedel. They're going to try to get the ball to her and see if she can
Ward
hit something.
Tries to go in, looking at the trees. It goes right above them. It's short. Ball goes out. Gray, who checks back in. Shyla Gray, she's going to go. She's going to put it up, and it's no good, but she's going to get called. And
gets fouled, go to the charity
strike.
That'll be two free throws at the charity strike for Oshyla Gray.
Two free throws for Gray. The team's not in the bonus quite yet, but we are getting there, folks. Cougars, as great of a game as they've been having, have gotten themselves into a bit of foul trouble this game.
Let's see if Oshyla Gray can convert from the charity strike, be able to maybe close the gap a little bit. But it's not looking good for the Corsairs right now. Down 17 points, 63-45 with about 7 minutes left in the game.
As they say in every sports movie ever invented, Josh, it's not over until it's over. We still got quite a bit of basketball here left, 7 minutes. And tune in here, folks. We got some good basketball going here back and forth. Friedel. Bank shot, it's good. Speaking of good basketball, Friedel gets it going. here with 7 minutes left here in the game, but it's looking good.
I don't know about you, but that thing's a thing of beauty. Turnaround, jump shot, bank. That's the fundamentals of basketball right there.
Strides of Tim Duncan right up there. Gray up top, crossover, gonna shoot it. Long mid-range, in and out. That thing was halfway in the basket. Gray has to be frustrated, but she's gonna get another chance because it looks like the Corsairs are gonna get the ball here. Looks inside for Seca, back out to Gray, who has the ball up at the top of the key. She's guarded by Brittany Martin. Ball inside to Evans. Evans is going to go up. It's no good. Two free throws coming up for Evans. Now 6:20 left here in the fourth. 65-46 Cougars. Kiana Evans going to try to cut into that lead. First free throw is short. No good. Now right now on the floor, you have Ashkenazi, you have Seca, you have Echevez, you have Gray, who actually just got that rebound right there. She's going to dribble. She's going to calm things down up at the top of the key. Martin guarding her. She's going to ask for that screen. Looks like she's going to give the ball out. Let's see if something can get going here for Chandler, sharing that backcourt with Gray. Ball up top, 8 seconds, 5 seconds left on the shot clock. Gray up and in, can't finish. Sarah Ward gets the rebound. It looks like Canyon's gonna still try to push things, get the score up, 24. A steal there by Gray, who is fouled. Looks like the foul is gonna be on number 24 for the Cougars, Brittany Martin.
One thing for certain tonight is the Corsairs came in with a game plan. They haven't been able to execute on offense, but they've really stuck true to their game plan on defense. The battle on the boards has been sort of close. They've been very aggressive defensively. They've had a bunch of steals, especially with O'Shea Gray, Mumu Seca, but they just can't convert on the offensive side. They just need another shooter. They need someone that could be able to just put the ball in the basket a little bit more to push them over the edge.
O'Shea Gray, man, she does have that beautiful crossover. That bucket right there, that jump shot that just went in by Gray, hasn't been going in tonight, but it's looked good. It's looked good. Hopefully an optimistic season here for the Cougars. And just like that, Hannah Green, who just checked into this game, knocks down the jump shot. We got a little bit more than 5 minutes here. 67-48 Cougars. And yes, folks, all of the starters right now are in for the Cougars.
Let's see if the Cougars can, if the Corsairs can answer. Shayla Gray.
Gray goes in. Teardrop is no good.
But grabs her own board.
She gets her own rebound. Gonna shoot the three, and that's a little long. Seca gets the offensive rebound. Another possession here. Let's see if the Corsairs can get something in here.
Second chance opportunities for the Corsairs, beating the Cougars at their own game, but they just can't convert them into second chance points.
Chandler gives it to Seca. He's gonna give it to Evans. Tries to go inside with it. She's blocked by Riley. Aaron Kiley, Rojas tries to get that pass in, but it's blocked by Seca. Tried to get it to Friedel there.
That's another steal for Seca. Her and Gray, they've been stealing all night long. Someone might need to call the local police.
Three-pointer there by Chandler is no good. Rojas is going to get the ball again. She's been running the fast break over and over for this Cougars team. She tried to put something up there. It's going to be an out of bounds. Cougars going to keep it here on this end of the court.
Looking just under 4 minutes. Corsairs trailing by 19. I'm not saying there is no chance of coming back, but it looks like the Cougars are going to be rolling away with the win and send the Corsairs packing with another loss on the season.
Interestingly enough, you have the Cougars up by what, as you stated, Josh, would seem like a comfortable lead here with a little bit less than 4 minutes to go. They have all of their starters in the game, pushing the pedal to the metal, as you might say. Aaron Kiley going to put it up. She's short.
Hannah Green with the offensive board.
Offensive rebound. She's going to go to the line and shoot two.
What's surprising tonight? I haven't seen the stat line. I can't confirm this yet, but Hannah Green has been struggling offensively. She hasn't been able to put the ball in the basket. However, I think she might still have a double-double tonight. I think she might have reached 10 rebounds, and I think she already has over 10 blocks.
At this point, I wouldn't be surprised if it was a triple-double. Let's be honest.
She might be coming pretty close to having a triple-double tonight. Well, Hannah Green is definitely one special player.
And you can say, it'd be an understatement to say this is a nice opener here for Hannah Green. Gray, who also has a nice conference opener here, really has the keys to this offense the entire game for the Corsairs. Coach Lydia Strong really trusts her with that. Looks like Gray is going to get two free throws. Not a lot of offense has been going on here for the Corsairs, but Oshilu Gray has been doing almost everything she can. 48 points so far for the Corsairs. First free throw was no good. She's going to try for the second one here. 68-42, 3:42 left here in the fourth. Corsairs down 19. Rojas has the ball up top. Going to give it to O'Brien, who gets the ball stolen. Nice job looking at the passing lanes by Seca. Oh, she lost her defender there. Couldn't quite finish, but Gray able to get the rebound and finish it herself. Oshilu Gray having a nice little game here.
Her and Mimusa Seca have really shown to be the two bright stars for the Corsairs.
Green turnaround jumper is good. Hannah Green getting it going here.
I think she is coming very close to that triple-double tonight.
Oshilu Gray up top. She's going to pull up. It's going to be
a rebound by Hannah Green.
Rojas brings it up court. Bounce pass, and it's good. Friedel.
It looks like the College of the Canyons are leaving their starters in because I'm not saying anything about their coach, but it looks like they're just trying to add some stats right now. It looks like they're trying to make it look a little bit better.
Let's put it this way. It's definitely getting close to the victory lap, and he's not taking his foot off the pedal at all.
And there is another block for Hannah Green. Well, if she didn't have 13 blocks yet, that could be 13. It might be 14. We don't know here at the booth. But, wow. Defensively on the boards, and now she's even starting to turn it up a little bit offensively.
Three by Echevez is good. Corsairs got that to go.
But it looks like it might be a little bit too little too late.
Aaron Kylie up and in.
And there's a defensive lapse let in Kylie, who I think is actually the points leader for the Cougars tonight.
Gray gets her shot blocked by guess who?
Hannah Green.
Who gets the rebound, actually, after blocking that shot. Flores going to try to work some near Kylie. Up. It's not quite there, but the rebound by Gray. Oshilu Gray going to take it up herself. She's going to try to get something going. Ball's going out of bounds.
Deflects off the shin of Hannah Green out of bounds. Wherever the ball is, that's where you're going to find Hannah Green. She's been around it all night long.
74-54 with 1:49 here left in the fourth. Cougars over the Corsairs. Looks like the inbound pass is going to go to Echevez, who made her last one. It's short this time. Seca, she's been active. She gets the offensive rebound. She gets the putback. Give the points to Seca. Rojas, Echevez did a good job right there. Staying pesky, gets the ball back. She's going to dribble it out. She's going to look for something. Rojas tries to do the same thing on the other end. Out of bounds. Corsairs ball here.
With only a minute and 29 left, I guess you can say that this is going to be another win for the College of the Canyons.
Extended
to 11-4.
You never know. You never know, Josh. Corsairs up top. It's going the other way. Another turnover there by the Corsairs. Well, Josh, you might have me a little bit convinced here. Looking a little meek here for the Corsairs. 1:19 left, down 18. It looks like the Corsairs are going to get some subs in.
Get some extra playing time for a few of those players a little bit further down the bench. it looks like the College of the Canyon Cougars will extend their season record onto 11-4 with six straight victories, and doing so in an impressive fashion, while the Corsairs will unfortunately fall to 4-11. It's definitely been a tough season. You have three season-ending injuries, especially to a few solid starters on the team.
First free throw is good by Rojas. She got the shooting foul there on the drive.
And there goes Hannah Green. I think she's subbed out for the rest of the game. That's been one impressive game.
Hannah Green comes out of the game. She might have a triple-double here, folks, and with blocks more than anything. Gray going to get the ball. Shiloh Gray, tough game for her, but she stuck through the entire time. Such an important part of this offense. Echeves tries to shoot the three. It's no good for the second time.
I think she's only converted on one tonight, and she's put up about six or seven. It's not been falling for her.
Echeves really has to spend her time on Rojas on the defensive end. She's had a good game overall, I'd say. Not able to really possibly hit all of her shots, but on the defensive end, she's been a pest. This Cougars team really coming into this game, believe it or not, they were favored. They were. Cougars did a good job of getting the job done, but Corsairs did a great job here of hanging in there. But it looks like at this point, with a little bit more than 30 seconds to go, the game will be going to the Canyons.
For all of you watching this game, stay tuned with us after this game. We'll actually see SMC face off against the College of the Canyons, but this time for the men's. And we'll see two good men's basketball programs facing off against each other. And we'll see how that goes.
Shot there is good by Gray. Canyons, they're going to come on the other end. There's like one second shot clock difference between the shot clock and the regular clock.
Another board for Ashkenazi. She's had a great game on the boards.
Shot clock is off. 12 seconds left in this game. It looks like the Corsairs are going to try to get another bucket here. But Aaron Kiley gets the steal. No look pass. Up. No shot. But she's going to get the foul. That is Tassie Ramon. She's going to get two. 2.7 seconds left here in the game.
I guess
Cougars will be shooting free throws.
I guess you can say that's just how the Cougars like to play, but come on. 3 seconds left. You still try to go for it. You can dribble out the clock. Instead, try to still go up and just keep the game going.
You got to do what you got to do, Josh. Some coaches really like to stick that aggressive mentality into their teams. Got to push the metal till the end of the game. It's really a philosophy thing, but I could see both sides. Corsairs will inbound the ball here. Looks like Gray's going to take the last shot. Half court heave. Oh, it almost looked good from here. But at the end of this one, folks, 77-59. College of the Canyons comes in and takes it over the Corsairs.
Well, that was the conference opener for the Corsairs as well as for the College of the Canyons. Definitely is going to be an interesting year for conference play. Corsairs look like they might have to be struggling a little bit. Might struggle for the rest of the season with some injury problems and finding some buckets. And the College of the Canyons looks like they're going to eat up the boards and have to rely on the big play of Hannah Green and Monica Friedel.
Now for my partner, Josh Scher, I'm Kevin Coe. Thank you for joining us for this game between the Santa Monica Corsairs and the College of the Canyon Cougars. Join us next time. We'll have a plenty full of games this season. This was just the conference opener. We got plenty more to come here, folks. We're excited to have you for this season, and I can't wait for some more basketball.
And definitely stay tuned. We're about to cover the men's basketball conference opening between the Cougars and the Corsairs. And we're going to throw it to our sideline reporter, who's going to have the post-game interview with Kelly Tittle.
Standing here with Coach Strong, so obviously a tough game, but there were a lot of shining moments. What do you hope to improve upon in practice this week moving forward into your next conference game?
I'd like to build on this, actually, because tenacity was really good. We just thought we needed to make a lot more shots inside, and some of the kids were timid, but I think we have a lot to build on. I think we'll be okay.
Okay. Well, good luck moving forward. Thank you
so
much.
Appreciate it.